That's Jay Leap also reporting there from Makhanda in the Eastern Cape a little bit earlier on. Well, for more on this story, let's join now from Gift of the Givers, Imtiaz Sooliman, who's in Cape Town. Thanks so much indeed for joining us. Welcome to the program. I'm sure that there was a difficult decision for you, but why did Gift of the Givers feel that they needed to pull out?
Hi, Peter. Yes, indeed, it was one of the most difficult decisions we had to make, because we know the need of water of the people. We've seen elderly people run toward our trucks. We've seen the different areas, how grateful they are when we bring the water. It's not going to be a few months that there's no water. It's going to be immediate. There'll be no water today and tomorrow and the next day in many areas in Makhanda. So it's instant, it's immediate. People don't have water. And the reason why we pulled out is because it was a matter of principle. We were promised, well, this is not a business agreement. When we entered the town, on the 12th of February, the municipality told us, look, we only need help for a few days because we're waiting for the pump to be repaired on the James Kleinans dam. We said, it's fine. And that wasn't a big issue for us. We brought in water, we brought in our trucks. We didn't expect to get paid for that because this is what we do normally. We help people. So we brought the water, we started helping the people. And then after a few days, when consulting the different people in the town and visiting the different areas, we realized this was a far bigger problem, that within a few weeks, the town is going to run out of water completely. And so we told the municipality, you guys need boreholes. You need underground water to pump into your dam, and you need to supply water to different areas in Jojo tanks. They told us, look, we don't have any money, and that's why we called you. I said, this is fine, but the cost of this is too high. Even we can't cover that cost. It's going to be between 23 and 30 million. So they said, look, we are going to declare, they asked the government to declare the area a disaster. We will then get emergency funding, and we will pay you with that funding to do these extra things that you have to do. You say it's expensive. The only thing is, we don't know if it will be declared a disaster. We don't know how much funding we'll get, and we don't know when we will get it. We said, that's fine. You know, in matter of, we will carry on doing what we can. They approached the government. It was declared a disaster. It was promulgated in the Gazette. And then the municipality had a meeting where it was unanimously tabled. That the moment the money comes, they will pay us. While this was happening, suddenly, we find the Department of Water and Sanitation starting to engage us. And we couldn't understand why that was taking place. Because they made a statement to say that once they give money to the municipality, they step back and the municipality chooses whom it wants. So we couldn't understand why they were engaging us. And they engaged us on several occasions. And finally, and they said, look, the money is coming. We're going to put the money into the municipality's account. And every time we check to the municipality, they say they don't have the money. The municipality calls us and asks us, did you get the money? We said, no, but the money is coming to you, and then you will pay us. So that to and fro carried on. And eventually, 2 days ago, the Department of Water and Sanitation, who say they don't interfere, who say the municipality makes their own decision, they called us and in a meeting told us 10 million is becoming available. And they've been putting public statements to say they gave 22 million to the municipality. So how it becomes 10 million, I don't know. And they said 10 million is now available, but it will not be paid to you. It will be paid to three different companies because the money has to go to companies in Grahamstown for work that we did. They didn't say that, but it was obvious. 1.2 million to a consultancy company. We did the consultation work. We did the report. We presented it to the municipality. Another company, 1.8 million, to connect the balls to the treatment plant, the electrical connections, which we are going to do. But these are our balls. It doesn't belong to anybody else. It belongs to us. We drilled and we paid for it. And thirdly, the best of it all, paying 7 million to another company for boreholes, and we drilled the boreholes. So as a matter of principle, we cannot accept taxpayers' money being paid to people who've done nothing for the town, and we've done all the work. So as a matter of principle, we said, okay, somebody else got the money, then they can fix the town and we will leave.
So these boreholes, they belong to you still. Can they access them?
Yes, they can access them, but the pumps are not on. We haven't put the pumps on because there was not enough money to pay for all that. It's not only about putting the pumps on. Mm. It needs special PVC piping to be put in the bowl. Otherwise, it'll collapse and it'll be wasted money. So, and also without the filtration systems, which we design ourselves. It's our own intellectual property rights. Nobody has those filtration systems in South Africa. It's our own design, our own innovation. Without that, they can't use the water. They need those systems, and those things cost 600,000 to 700,000 in each.
So from what I'm hearing, the problem in this story is the Department of Water and Sanitation. The municipality itself had a gentleman's agreement with you that you would be compensated for work done. And it seems that the Department of Water and Sanitation have taken another route.
That's exactly the story. We have an excellent relationship with the municipality. They were honest with us from the first day. They said, look, we have no money. You're coming in here, you need to understand. I said, look, we don't ask for money when we do these things. We're a charity organization. But the work that has to be done here to save the town, in fact, the university was worried. They said students have started falling out. The enrollment had dropped in the university. And the town is dependent on the university. Jobs are going to be lost. The economy is going to be affected. Tourists wouldn't come. The Standard Bank Arts Festival is in trouble in June if the thing is not sorted out before then. All these things we considered, and when there's so much unemployment in the country, you didn't want the whole university town to collapse. So we said we'll start on our own. And they said, look, we don't know if we'll get the money, and we don't know how much we'll get, and we don't know when we'll get it. But all that was honest. We had no problem with all that. But when the Department of Water and Sanitation comes and says we've got 10 million, but we're not giving to you, then that's a major problem.
So, again, if I follow the thread of your story, we've got three companies that are going to be paid for work that they haven't done. That's fraud.
Well, that's why the public is up in arms. But also, okay, forget the fraud part. Mm. The reality is, how are they going to get water tomorrow?
Right, right.
There is no system of giving the people water tomorrow. They are going to be in a serious crisis.
So what needs to happen for you to be able to go back, put in the pumps, and get the operation running again?
Before we get to the pumps part, for the last 3 to 4 weeks, we're basically, in inverted commas, wasting time. Because we've only been delivering water in tankers, when you can do something far more efficient than that. If we had connected the pumps, if the money had come, we could have connected the pumps, we would have pumped water into the dam, 4 million liters of water would be pushed from the dam into the reservoirs. We wouldn't have to send tankers there. People would get the water in their taps. We would have put in more filtration systems in the school where we can draw 1.2 million liters of water, purify that water through our filtration systems, and only use tankers in those areas while the big dam gets fixed. And after a few weeks, when the big dam is fixed, there's no need for us to put water tankers in that area because people on one side of the town will get the water. So we're a stopgap measure while they're fixing the infrastructure in the town. To answer your question, if they say yes, the money is available, we'll go back tonight because we know the people are in serious trouble. We'll bring in more water tankers while we're drilling the earthwork to put the pipes in, to put the water into the dams. We'll have to put concrete slabs all over the city to hold the Jojo tanks because they're weighty. And then we have to bring in more water tankers to pump water from our own bowls through our own filtration systems to put into those Jojo tanks so people don't have to walk long distances, don't have to run after a truck, don't have to come after work and find they've missed the truck so they can get water at any time.
Does the Minister of Water and Sanitation Department know about this issue? Have you engaged with Minister?
Well, we haven't engaged him directly because we were talking to the people from the Department of Water and Sanitation, and this happened 2 days ago. And obviously, somewhere along the line, they know the processes they've got to follow. They know the system that they followed. So for them to take a decision not to pay us, obviously, everybody in the department must be knowing about that. In any case, when this thing hit the news today, we got a call from the president's office. We got a call from the Minister of Ibrahim Patel. His office called us to say they're looking into the matter. The president's office said they're looking into the matter. Jackson Muntemdu called me this afternoon to say they're looking into the matter. He's calling the Minister of Water directly. Ibrahim Patel's office said they're calling the Minister of Water directly. And just a little while ago, we got a call from somebody from the Department of Water and Sanitation saying that the Director General wants to discuss the matter and they want to have a meeting with the municipality and the role plays. We said it's the same thing all over again. We've been doing this for 13 weeks. We've spent hundreds of hours in meetings. It's a simple solution. Have you guys got the money or don't you have the money? If you don't have the money, tell us it's fine. If you have the money, you need to pay for us to finish the job. There's no long discussion required. You've declared this an emergency and you're taking 13 weeks to solve a problem which is an emergency. What is your definition of an emergency?
And of course, the cost of not fixing this is far greater than the funds that are being withheld.
Yes, most certainly. But more than that, the funds, being with, the people are paying the price.
Yeah.
And the best thing in all this, on Freedom Day, When the president came to speak in Makhanda, the municipality told us, please, we don't have water for the town. You know that, they told us. And we don't have water for all the guests coming from all over, from all the Eastern Cape. We prepared 126,000 liters of water, with bottled water. We brought in water, the water tankers. And whilst the president was speaking, we got a call from the Department of Water and Sanitation to say, can you please move your trucks? It is an embarrassment. There is no water crisis in Makhanda. Wow. 5 minutes later in the speech, President Cyril Ramaphosa says, there's no freedom for the people of South Africa and no freedom for Makhanda if there's no water in Makhanda.
All right. Imtiaz Sooliman, thanks very much indeed for talking to us today. Let's hope this matter gets resolved very quickly because it is, as you've described, an emergency that needs to be dealt with. Thank you so much indeed for your time.
It's a pleasure.
All right, so that was Imtiaz Sooliman from Gift of the Givers, the humanitarian organization, desperately trying to help the people of Makhanda with the critical water shortage and doing work there, but wanting the Department of Water and Sanitation to do their bit to help the people of the Eastern Cape.